Bro, you should have been at a party the other night. No, you wasn't here. I'm tripping.
EA
Well,
Sports
he was
to the
playing
game.
one of the. He's playing somebody, bro. Nigga kept praying to God, all this and that. God, please be on my side, God. Cause I already know what you thinking, nigga. This your first game back on against me. You see what we doing, man. You see what we been doing to niggas, man. You probably think you still, you mean? Oh, well, that's cool. We going, boy. My first game of the day, man. Let's go. Bitch, but I should've come here.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to South Florida at Hard Rock Stadium here in Miami. Coming up, we got a good matchup on tap here, as it'll be the Philadelphia Eagles taking on the Miami Dolphins. Here's the kicker, Jake Elliott, ready to get this one started. And we are underway from Hard Rock Stadium. And this is going to be returned from the middle of the end zone. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out.
My name is Samir.
Not a good one. Two and a throw right away. That's over the middle, caught by Chosen. 4 yards the result on the first play from scrimmage. Second down.
And I think this is a route we'll see more of as this game goes on, because with his speed, they want to get him the ball in space on drag routes just like this. They want him to get the ball and run after the catch. Good job there, though, holding him for a short gain.
Tagovailoa to throw on second down here. Now the pressure comes and he goes down. Just inside the 10, back at the 9. Josh Sweat rushing in and bringing him down to the ground. Just two plays in, and Charles already their first sack defensively.
Yeah, how about that? That didn't take long, did it? And now they look at third down, and that's another time to try and go and get the quarterback too.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And this one is incomplete.
Yeah.
Some applause for the defense. Yeah. There. They forced him to throw that one into coverage, and just like that, they're staring at a fourth down. Well done.
The Dolphins will send out the punter now, as his first punt will come from inside his own end zone. And taken right on the 30. So a good punt, but a solid 12-yard return. And the Eagles will have it taking over first and 10. They'll start on the ground with Swift. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Tackled by Bradley Chubb, the number 5 pick in the 2018 draft. Here's second and 10. Hurts. Oh, it's first
down again. Gonna be it's like I knew I was going to do that. I still do this shit.
In motion, Hill. After the turnover, it's Tua. He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone.
He's
Tyreek Hill, 45 yards. And the Dolphins take the early turnover and convert it into an opening touchdown. Jason Sanders now for the extra point. And that makes it 7-0 Dolphins. Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. And we'll see a return here from
that.
The end zone.
I'm going at
the defender.
I'm
and
going
he returns at. This to the 22.
He ate the shit out that first hit. Real nigga.
They threw an interception the first time they had the football, wound up leading to a touchdown the other way. How do you approach drive number 2?
Going back to your game plan coming in, everyone has matchups that they like better than others, where they think they have an advantage. Dial up some of those plays. Try and go to those spots and get your offense moving.
Ball on the 27. Here's second down and 5.
Tickets for Sunday.
Here's Hurts to throw. That's caught by the big tight end, Dallas Goedert. And Goddard going to have an Eagles first down as the tackle made up near the 35. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
Boy, I'm on.
Swift going to try up the middle. And he gets forward up the middle, but only for a couple. It'll be second down.
You've got to be impressed by the defensive front on reps like those. They were not being moved off the line, kept their shoulders square, and gave their teammates time to fight to the ball and limit that game.
High throw it, nigga!
Oh, he brings it in off the deflection. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. It's a gain of 16.
That was top tier bailout. I ain't gonna lie. They bailed me the fuck out. They bailed me the fuck out. You hear me? I ain't gonna lie.
Get that one out quickly to Brown. Give him a gain of 5 on the completion, and that'll bring up second down. With these run pass options, we often talk about a good quarterback and running back. Well, having a talented wide receiver helps also.
Yeah, even coming in 3rd in the discussion. Sometimes that means he really should be 1st, because all you want to do is get the ball in their hands and let them make the big plays downfield.
This will be caught once again by Brown. And he's got another 1st down as he's brought down at the Dolphins 33. They picked up 5 yards last time. Now they double it and get 10 here. So they'll come up 1st and 10 now from the 33. Get it. They will run straight ahead with Swift.
Hey, what
the
fuck?
Can up the middle, 3 yards. That'll bring up second down.
Not a huge carry there on first down, but not all of them will be. But still, all in all, a positive play for the offense. It's all about picking up at least a few to set up what you're going to do here on second down.
Oh, and his early struggles continue. Here's another intercepted. Picked off by Verone McKinley. And the Dolphins are going to have the football here at their own 35-yard line. First down, Miami, as they get set to start the drive.
Well, partner, you know, coaches always say that every play is designed to score a touchdown. Sometimes that's not really true, but last drive, that was the case. One play to get into the end zone, and now they'll try to duplicate that success here.
And it's rare for those moments to happen. Incredible when they do.
And now this is intercepted. My goodness. Picked off by James Bradbury. And the Eagles are going to get possession of the football as time will run out on its first quarter of play. After 1-7-0 on EA Sports. On first and 10, it's Swift.
Come on, get on the block.
He's able to navigate his way down inside the 30. 12 yards is the pickup. Good for an Eagle first.
Every
down.
Time I do it, I do it for my.
Bert sets
up. Understood. I do it for the.
For Swift. And he stopped right at the 25 after a gain of 5.
Now that's the type of play that gives you a chance to win. Nothing forced downfield where you don't have a guy open. Swing it out to the back and maybe even check it down, whatever you want to call it. Gain of 5. You're just trying to get 4 on first down. They're ahead of the chain.
Fuck!
Throwing again on second down, but this time it's incomplete.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really. They come up now, 3rd and 5, following the incomplete pass. Throwing is Hurts.
Yeah, what the fuck? This nigga Swift, yo.
It's incomplete.
Nigga Swift running in front of him.
They needed to come through the completion there. Now drive that started with great field position is facing.
That was some bullshit right there, sir.
Hurts not coming to the sideline. They're going to go for it. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. He's got his target. That's complete. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the 5 all the way to the 3. Swift. We'll get down close to the goal line, but not in, as he'll be marked down at the 1. Only a yard that time, 2nd and goal.
Good work there, holding him out on first down, and this is going to be a battle down here on the goal line. Can they hold their ground for 2, maybe even 3 more plays?
2nd and goal from the 1. Oh, the sneak, it's Hurts. And they will stop him after a fairly minimal pickup. Successful from a yard out, and the Eagles are an extra point away now from tying this ball game.
And these Eagles may have been the first
50K alone.
This play. Let Hurts take the snap.
Right.
Get some help pushing from behind. This was so successful. Some folks, including me, were calling for this play to be outlawed. But while it's still in the books, no one runs it better than Hurts, and he takes this one in.
Elliott good on the extra point, and we are tied at 7. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. Braxton Berrios now from his end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line.
The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. Two and the Dolphins now with a first and 10 at their own 16. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw.
That's the safety.
After the sack, oh, they're staring at a challenge basically from the other side of town. It's second and a country mile. And they'll send the slot in motion left.
21G.
And they will not get the snap off here. This is going to back them up halfway. That flag accepted, and it backs the offense up a little bit. Looking to pass to him. That's caught by the Notre Dame man. It's Durham Smythe. Here now, third and a yard. Tagovailoa working out of the gun. He'll swing this out to Mostert. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. They'll wind up losing a yard on the play. And it'll be fourth down.
No surprise they decided to throw on third down. A little bit of a surprise that they completed the pass and lost yardage on the play.
And how about the call here? They need 2 yards in their own territory on fourth down, and they're going to go for it. They're going for it. Here's Tua with it.
Fuck! That nigga put jump.
And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. A curious decision to go for it, but it pays off with a first down. Again, they will throw it with Tagovailoa. Getting this out to the flat, Mostert. Just a gain of a couple there. And that's going to bring up second down. The Dolphins moving with a sense of urgency here.
That's a 45-yard line.
Let's go.
On second down, Tua. And he'll throw this one away. But I don't think he was out of the pocket. No, here comes the flag.
That nigga did it,
nobody in the vicinity of that throw, and that earns him the penalty.
Yeah, you've got to at least get it close enough to one of your own guys in order to dodge the penalty.
So now it's third and long, because remember, they also lose a down on the grounding call.
Bitches really fuck with her.
From the gun, it's Tua.
I didn't know the bitch was fucking with her like that.
Oh, the turnover fest continues. Here's another interception. Picked off by...
Oh, get the fuck out the way!
This is a situation where a quarterback coach in the sideline is going to talk to a signal caller and say, listen, it's third and long. It's early in the game. Let's not force things here. If we don't feel good about it, let's just check something down and pump the football.
On first and 10, it's Hurts. He finds his man complete. That's Watkins. First down now, but that clock rolling. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And this is incomplete. Very lucky to get that one back. And nearly picked. It's second down now.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
Play action. Here's Hurts. And he's going to be intercepted for the third time thus far.
And the dumbest shit happens to me. Nigga scores. Every time I throw a pick, it's always some bullshit.
And he is not quite gonna make it.
Bullshit.
What
the fuck, man?
Stop. The best starting man, field bro. Position you could possibly have. First and goal from the one. Mostert.
Sonny, what the fuck?
Into the end zone. Touchdown. Touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot. A lot of tight ends just use their size and their strength, try to occupy some space and kind of body people away and catch the football. But not this guy. He's a refined route runner. Makes me wonder if he took some dance classes in his background with his footwork.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. He'll drop to throw. That is caught. It's the tight end Goddard. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. Big yardage after the catch. That one winds up going for 36.
Despite writing it down on my notes, I never give enough credit to the offensive line, and we have to here. The protection, that's what made this play a success. Quarterback had to wait for his crossing route to develop, and that takes a little bit of extra time. Excellent job by the big fellas up front.
So the run play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10, just outside the 30. They'll look to throw. Going across the middle, and Goddard's got it. Now here's a timeout as they're going to get it with 8 seconds remaining here in the first half. Now a first and 10 at the 11. Back to throw again.
What is you doing? Yo, throw the ball! They not trying to let me throw the fucking ball, man. They ain't let me throw the fucking ball,
man. Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. A one touchdown ball game, 14-7 our scores. We get back at it on EA Sports.
No, nigga, he pushed the shit out of him. Fuck you think this is, nigga? Oh, wake up, Lee.
Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. Well, Charles, we saw a pretty entertaining first half, close ball game. Remember there toward the end of the second quarter, the opposition scored to take the lead. Now we'll see if these guys can get a score of their own to regain that lead.
Yeah, they want to have that type of a response, don't they? Because they want to find a way to take control of this. They want to see if they're ready to answer.
They can muster only a yard there. They'll be left with a third.
Here come what, nigga? Look, you talking about here come, nigga. You're not doing that. I'm ass, nigga.
First down as the tackle made just shy of the 40. Well, they gave themselves options there on the third down play and were able to convert on that RPO.
Shows a lot of trust with the guy taking the snap, doesn't it? Because you're counting on him to make the right reads and give
shut
him
up, nigga.
Supposed to go. And he did on that play.
And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And they'll be left with
what
a
she gonna do? Me with you. This for you. Oh, baby.
We talk a lot about setting the tone to start the game. Well, you want to start the tone right in the third quarter as well. And nearly just a football there in the first
quarter. And sometimes we overdo it when we talk about halftime adjustments and what teams are going to do. Most of the time, it's just a matter of executing the game plan you brought in. But I guarantee you, they didn't.
How you call yourself hop out? You ain't pop shit.
He was held without a catch in the first half, but he's got one here, and he also picks up a first down.
That boy in the zone. That boy in the zone.
He'll get it inside the 20.
That boy in the zone, boy. That boy in the zone, boy.
Back to the running game with Swift. 45 yards rushing for him now to this point.
And when you get good yardage like that on first down, it really does a whole lot of good for your entire offense. But I love the way he's finishing those runs. At the end of things, he's making sure he gets just a little bit extra.
From the six now on second and three.
See you wanna be.
Hurts.
Yo, let me escape,
man. That time Bradley Chubb shooting in there for the sack. Well, we saw him score on the ground earlier in the ball game. This time the defense says not so fast.
Yeah, that's good scouting and good awareness, isn't it? Because you always have to be wary of him keeping it himself, especially in this part of the field. Because if he doesn't like what he sees, you know he'll take off and try and go for it himself.
Yeah, the Eagles are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points.
Fuck my man up. Damn.
Catch is expected. Red zone presence. And that one was realized there. You've got to find your tight end in that situation.
Touchdown, Eagles. Jalen Hurts on target to Dallas Goedert. And the Eagles are an extra point away from drawing level. Well, that's just how they drew it up, CD. His first read was there, got it to him quickly, and into the end zone.
Absolutely excellent execution by all involved. And the coordinator, got to give him credit, found the perfect play call. Quarterback let it fly as soon as the target came free, and his guy made a nice catch. Just how you draw it up in practice, and execute it in the game.
So all square here in this third quarter as the kick's away. And this will be a touchback. Berrios deciding not to bring it out. The Dolphins at the line, ready for the next drive. Their halftime lead now evaporated. We're back to level following that touchdown.
Offensive
perspective, because they already knew this was going to be a
fuck is he doing, man?
Intercepted for the third time.
I tell you, Brandon, it seems like this guy's been all over the field so far. That's his second interception of the game. And so much defense in the NFL, especially when it comes to defending the pass, is all about positioning and technique. And this is fantastic work on both fronts there.
Here's a toss play right to Swift.
Woo! Woo! That was a touchdown!
And the offense offense moving quickly to the line. 10 yards. Right back to Swift again on second down. And this one goes.
Because he's a, I don't respect him, bro. Like.
22. It'll go as a loss of a yard, and it'll set up third down.
Say no, bro. Say no, bro. Say no, bro. Take it easy, bro. Take it easy, bro. Take it easy, bro. Smack!
They'll drop to throw. And he'll take it into the end zone for an Eagles touchdown. Jalen Hurts, a 6-yard touchdown run. And the Eagles have scored again in the third quarter. This time to move.
That nigga Ramsey had a 3-quarter suspension. Finna run it up. What time is it? For Fed A.
If you're gonna play quarterback in the NFL, you've gotta have great vision and you've got to remain calm when things break down in the pocket. Both of those traits are on display there. He surveys the situation, sees the middle of the field open, so he's just gonna step up and take it himself. Very well done there.
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. Hill is going to take it out of the end zone. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20.
Sweet.
And this should be the final play before the quarter ends. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. And he's going to lose yardage here. As they will switch ends as time has run out on this third quarter of play. Back now in Miami. It's Dolphin football, but they trail here as we get set for the fourth. So after the sack, a scenario you certainly don't work on too often. Second and 24. Here's Tua. Wide open receiver complete.
Wide open.
0 for 3 to this point. They could use a conversion. This time it's third and 3. They'll try and run here with Mostert. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. A Miami first down. That one going for a gain of 11. Now Tua. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away.
And a smart play there. He's
don't fall on your head, Tua. Don't fall on your head. Interception.
Tua sets up to pass it. Short throw hauled in by Croft.
Damn. Damn.
The drive continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's first and 10. Here's Tagovailoa to throw. Flush to his right. And he wisely will throw that one away.
Hop on him, sign him.
We've seen this quite a few times in this game. Offensive line unable to keep leverage, unable to keep people away. Facing a lot of
hit that nigga.
Fortunate just to get rid of it.
One of the reasons they're down is that inability, though, to stop the pressure. We saw another example of it there. Tua setting up shop to throw again.
Ooh, that shit was wide open. That shit was wide open. Fuck, nigga.
To the end zone has hit a momentary roadblock with that incompletion. No need to panic. They just got to come up with a high percentage play call and see if they can get their offense back on track.
Throwing is Tagovailoa on third down here. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Well, I think think we were both wondering if we were going to see them try and push it deep downfield, facing a one-possession deficit late, and they certainly didn't disappoint. They gave it an effort.
44.
One score down, here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. Fourth down, fourth quarter, here's Tua.
And for the first time tonight, it's an interception. That's rude. Third down.
Reed Blankenship. And the Eagles are in great shape here as they take over at their 46-yard line. Yes, folks, that is his third interception, and I'm going to use one of the most overused phrases in football. He's a ball-hawking safety.
I love the way that you call for
what the fuck?
There. That's perfect, though, because there is
Tua, what the fuck?
That being a safety often allows you freedom to roam around the defense, maybe not a specific assignment. Today, his assignment, find the football, and he's done so quite well.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away, but the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
Now it's second and 10. Here's a handoff to Swift. And he's across midfield and into Miami territory. 60 yards rushing for him now in the ball game.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against him.
This a big play for both sides. What will we see here? Third and four. Throwing is Hurts. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. That goes for a gain of 31.
Well, my dad would say sometimes, I'm just scratching my head trying to figure out what was going on there defensively. How did you lose him in the middle of the field? If you're going to lose a receiver, make sure it's someone on the short side of things, not deep downfield, that can hurt your defense.
So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. Here's Hurts to throw. Open man is Goddard, the tight end. And he's got this inside the 10 to the 9 before he's out of bounds. So the completion results there in 9 yards. And that'll give him a short yardage situation here for second down. He delivers another to Goddard, complete. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down.
Well, he does have one touchdown in the game already, and while this one won't go for six, it's enough to get him first and goal, but you and I both know he's going to be a little upset he didn't cross the goal line for a second time in this one.
Might want the ball here on the next play. And he will take this one in for an Eagle touchdown. DeAndre Swift, a 6-yard touchdown run. And the Eagles have opened up a 2-touchdown lead here in this fourth quarter.
Well, this offensive line has really stepped up to the challenge here because those Mastodons, they've been sensational clearing holes all game long. And this is great work down here near the goal line to give their back the space he needs to work his way into the end zone.
Elliott Good with a PAT and a lead up to 14.
I'm on my other side.
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on the kick it away. Hill is going to take it out of the end zone. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20. At their own 20-yard line. Here's first and 10. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. And he's taken down. Back at his own 7. The defense rising to the challenge and setting him back on the sack. Here's second down. Here's Tua. And that is going to be incomplete as he led him a bit too much. Another throw there off the mark, and obviously he's battled all of the interceptions. Things just haven't been true to form for him. I don't know. What do you think's going on out there, CD?
That's a great question, and my suspicion is he's been coached really well to not show that he's having a problem. You know, they always...
And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by Reed Blankenship, and he brings it back to right around the 26-yard line. And give him...